okay, if we look at the skin and look at the part where the horse sweats the most, horses sweat like humans in order to cool themselves off. The most sweat glands are on the side of the horse. As a matter of fact, what we call this part on the saddle, right here, we call the bottom part right there sweat flap. That's why we have the most amount of sweat accumulation right to the side. Now, I've been told is when the horse runs in the wild and is out of breath and it's totally sweaty, if the wind hits the larger surface area from the side, that cools the horse off very fast. Very, very rare you see a lot of sweat glands or sweat on top of the back. So the question comes, why do we see a sweat pattern where your saddle sits? Well, again, as I mentioned, the biggest sweat you see right here, if this is the front of the saddle, from the sweat flap. Where your tree sits, you see additional areas where the saddle has this right here is the stirrup bar, you got the gullet plate, your tree. So if we have the most sweat glands on the side, why do they sweat on top? Let's keep in mind that the shoulder blade, when the shoulder blade moves, it moves 6 to 8 inches further back. So we have constant shoulder coming back and forth. Right here where the last rib is and where the lumbar starts, we have also the biggest movement where the back goes up and down. So we have a lot of movement in this vicinity and in this vicinity. And sweat is created by airflow and friction. So when you look at the saddle pad from the top down, you sometimes, if this is a big square pad, you see an area right here where the channel is clear. And you see like a kidney shape almost, dry spot on your saddle pad. That would be folded right on top here where your saddle tree is. Right here where your stirrup bar is. This area where that metal part is and where the gullet plate is the area what looks like a kidney shape. This kidney shape where the metal and the gullet plate from the stirrup bar as well as the gullet plate is where the saddle does not move. So we have no friction. The front part of the saddle, where the sweat flap is, the back part of the saddle, here where we have movement, the back goes up and down. Here where the shoulder goes back and forth. Here we have a lot of friction, airflow. Therefore, we have sweat in this area and sweat in this area. Right there where the kidney shape is, there's no friction. Therefore, you will not have any sweat right in that area. And it sweat, the dry spot looks like that, you are okay. Most of the time, when it's really hot, that's the last area what will get sweaty too. If, however, the dry spot is here, here, or anywhere along the back where no metal is, where friction should be and airflow, and the dry spot is the size of a silver dollar, then that's a pressure point and that's a bad dry spot. So as a thumb rule, to protect the horse's skin, we like to see even sweat marks. And if I have a dry spot, what looks like that, I'm okay.